anything, and we start with David Lighty. Please, thanks.
So David, did you believe it was possible before this game?
Oh yes, for sure. You have to have confidence in your team, and I think the coaches came up with a good game plan, and you know, it's just about us going out and executing and pretty much, you know, giving it all we got. And at the end of the day, you just live with the outcome.
Okay, and what do you think, what does make the difference tonight?
Team defense, just everyone played a vital part in it. Everyone made plays when we needed it, whether it be the beginning of the game or the second half. I think we came out in the third quarter and started pretty strong, and that gave us a lot of momentum to carry on down the stretch.
And what is your next goal now?
We'll see what happens with the draw, see what matchup we get, and you know, just game plan from there, watch video, and you know, pretty much try to do the same thing. We have to use this as momentum, and keep going.
Okay, thank you. Coach?
No. Question for David or the coach. The team never panic when Le Mans start to take the lead. You never panic in the match.
I think that that's just basketball. You know, we've all been playing pretty much all of our lives. You know, it's a game of runs. It's up and down always. And you know, good teams, they pretty much, you know, deal with it. You know, take the punch, and then throw a punch back. So for us, it's just about, you know, not letting a team get comfortable and trying to make it as you know, hard as possible on them, you know, to score the ball.
Okay, thank you, David. Now, question for the coach, please.
Okay, first of all, please, before the question, I would like to say some special thanks, because you know, we are talking about something really historic for our society, something really important, because in the last month we were able to find and reach the final Italy Cup, and now we are in the first eight of this really tough competition, playing for the first group, playing against unbelievable teams that are going, everybody are going really in fantastic way. So we spend a lot of energy for recover, because like you know, we start so-and-so the beginning of the season. So I want to say thanks for, first of all, my society, because they give us the possibility to come here with the charter, and we will rest a little bit that we needed, because today was our 42 games official, or 42 or 43 games, I don't remember, official game, and give us possibility to arrive back home tonight. And so we have one day more for prepare the next game against Milan, an important game. So I want to say thanks to my owner for this, because you know, we are talking about something that is not usual in European team. Second, I want to say thanks absolutely to my staff, because they work like animal every day, and they give possibility to players and to me to make our job in perfect way. And third, I want to say thanks to these players, because tonight was a really tough game, and they never lost the way to play, and to play fantastic defense against a really good team and athletic team. And so when you watch your players take nine bounce more than Le Mans, talking about athletic teams, athletic players, means that everybody put something more than 100%.
Okay, did you think more about the difference of the points during all the game or the victory?
No, I believe that the most important thing is that you don't have to watch a lot the scoreboard, because scoreboard kill you, because you start thinking. And like in game one, I believe that the key is that you have to play all the balls like, you know, the last ball in the game, doesn't matter which is the score, the difference between the two teams that are playing. And also, you know, tonight was really important that if you start thinking that you are in front by 16, you have a problem. It's clear, because I agree with this question. No panic was the best way to attack Le Mans, because if you go in panic when Le Mans make that break 9-0 and they stay in front by 7, you can have absolutely problems, and in that way you go in the worst way that you can go. So
it's tough to prepare yourself when you have to play 80 minutes, but I believe that is the only way that you have it.
Thank you.
Okay, that is Italian journalist.
Mi sono perso la prima parte.
No, in English, please.
Sì, yes, I would like to know how you prepared the second part of this game during half time. The game was still open.
We prepared the game thinking about that. The difference was when we attack Picarol going in the middle and when we attack Picarol going on the side. Because Le Mans playing defense on Picarol going on the side, they put on you their athletic body, their quality. And so you have a problem because after that the ball is not able to come out quick and you are not able to make the triangle in offense. So changing some calls and in offense around the system and playing Saint Picarol coming from the side to the middle, we can find the right way also for the shooter, not only for the guards. And so in that way, Dusko Savanovic have open shots and also other players like Hercules open shot. That was one key. And second key was that we have to go under on pick and roll with number four because the difference was that every time Cornelio Pearson was able to change the angle of the screen, we have a problem. And after that, I talk all about the confidence because I believe that some part of the game, when the game is 80 minutes, it's better that you work on the player's head, thinking of pushing them to have a lot of confidence. Doesn't matter if they miss one shot or one free throw, like happened with Brian and Lighty. Okay?
Thank you.
Good luck for all. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. We continue with Olivier, please.
Yes, Olivier, did you expect to have this kind of game tonight?
You know, we started off the game good. I felt like we didn't really finish off the court as good when we're up by, you know, a couple points. But, you know, they're a good team. They played good at home in that last quarter that kind of put us in a hole. And they did a pretty good job tonight just scoring and being patient down the stretch.
And the last game, it was also the last quarter, I think. The same thing?
Yeah, I think it was a bit the same thing. But I felt like, you know, today we did a pretty good job on defense in terms of just being aggressive and trying a few things that the coach kind of put in practice and just kind of pressuring them and making them turn over the ball. I think we missed a lot of easy looks, you know, a couple balls that slipped and a couple missed layups, a couple missed hand ones and stuff like that. So, you know, whenever you look at the game tape, you know, you kind of remember those plays. But like I said, they're a good team. They did a good job, you know, throughout these two last games, and they won.
Is it difficult to play and always thinking about the gap you have to?
Oh, yeah, you try to not think about it and trying to be aggressive. But obviously, you know, in a game like this one, you have to win by X amount. You obviously think about it. And I think we did a pretty good job. Sometimes we're up by 5, 6, 7, and you know we had to get a couple more stops to go into the next quarter and kind of keep that momentum. But you know, we made a couple mistakes down the stretch, and they kind of capitalized on it, and you know, they took advantage of it.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay, Alex.
So during 20 minutes. For 25 minutes, only 5 players took points. What happened at that?
I think we still have a lack of confidence. What I mean is that some players are doubting just a bit and missing some layups, some easy things close to the basket, so it hurts a bit.
You still, it was possible when you were the half, because you lead by 8 at
seven.
One moment. Mm-hmm. 7, yes, 8, and 7, 8. And you believe in it was possible in the second half?
Yes, like we said from the beginning, we were playing possession by possession. And so we just tried to play hard and to mix it up on defense, just to make them doubt. Unfortunately, one more time, we had some sleepy balls or some easy basket we just missed. And at the end of the game, if you can remember all those easy baskets we missed, we can have some regrets. But one more time, like O said, it was a very good team. And I think we lost the qualification over there and not here. Because if we only lose by, let's say, 6 or 8 over there, which was pretty much the case, 5 minutes left over there. I think it's not the same game here.
And without disqualification, what is your next goal now?
Well, we have a very important game upcoming now against Paris to stay in the race for the qualification for the playoff. And then 3 days after, we have the semi-final of the French Cup. So we will rest, we will watch the clips, try to fix our mistakes, and then just move on.
And the motivation is still there?
For sure, for sure.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.